Dear students, now after finishing our oxidative addition reactions, now we will start the reductive eliminations. Reductive elimination reactions, actually they are reverse of that of reductive elimination. So this deductive elimination is also an intermediate step of homogeneous catalytic cyclic processes. So it is the requirement before the study of homogeneous catalytic reactions. So in this lecture I will discuss all about the reductive elimination reactions, what are the factors that affect these reductive elimination reactions, and how they can occur, what are the mechanism of reductive elimination reactions. So these reductive elimination reactions are reverse of that of oxidative addition reaction. Reverse means they are not in equilibrium, but how the mechanism of oxidative addition reactions takes place, the opposite mechanism, opposite reaction will be the reductive elimination. Not necessarily they are in equilibrium, but they can occur separately. They can occur separately because they require some conditions. So the molecule should have some conditions so that it can show, either it can show this oxidative addition reaction or it can show the reductive elimination. They are the reverse. The changes occurring in the reductive elimination reactions, they are just reverse that of oxidative addition reaction. So we are saying it as reverse of oxidative addition reaction. Now, in this case, the oxidation state of metal reduced by 2 units. Because this is reductive elimination, so two terms, one is reductive. Reductive means reduction, reduction of metal center. So its oxidation state will decrease by 2 units. Generally 2 units, but it may be decreased by 1 unit also. As in case of oxidative addition, the oxidation state can increase by 2 units or by 1 unit. So, we can say that in reductive elimination, reduction and elimination, two parts are there. So, first is the reduction in the oxidation state, and the other is the coordination number in electron count will also reduce during the reductive elimination reaction. As these two things, coordination number and electron counts, they are increasing in oxidative addition. So, in this case, they are decreasing because elimination takes place, so coordination number will decrease, and the reduction causes the decrease in oxidation state of the metal center. So the general example of this reaction is this. So in this case, you can see this is a complex, and when it undergoes reductive elimination reaction, then it can eliminate these ligands XY, and this metal ligand complex will remain as such. So you can remember that this opposite reaction is the oxidative addition reaction, and this forward reaction is the reductive elimination. So you can see that its coordination number is decreasing because these two ligands they are eliminating. So its coordination number will decrease by 2. This is the coordination number. If it is, its coordination number is C, then its will be C minus 2. Then electron count will decrease by 2 in this reaction, and oxidation state will also decrease by 2. Hence it is called as reductive elimination reaction. And the reductive elimination reactions, they generally occur in presence of sunlight, or they are encouraged by oxidation. So in presence of sunlight or sometimes at higher temperature, reductive elimination reactions may occur. These are the metal centers which can show reductive elimination reactions. So they include D8 configuration. D8 configuration includes nickel second, palladium second, and this gold third. And D6 metal centers, they are platinum 4, palladium 4, iridium 3rd and rhodium 3rd. These metals, they are prone to reductive elimination reaction because there should be certain characteristic of the metal complexes that can show reductive elimination reactions. So these are the general configurations which can show reductive elimination reaction. The other thing about the reductive elimination reaction is that in homogeneous catalytic processes, reductive elimination is usually the last step and is responsible for the final product formation. Okay, So I have already taught you the homogeneous and heterogeneous catalysis, difference between these two. And you have seen that homogeneous catalytic processes, they occur through catalytic cycles, and the last step of these cycles is generally reductive elimination reaction. The reductive elimination reaction of the reactions that involves H are very fast. So actually, the reductive elimination reactions, including H, elimination of H, they are prone to reductive elimination reactions, and they are very fast. So in this, in this reaction, you can see here the elimination of hydrogen is correlated. So its reductive elimination rate of reaction will be very fast as compared to these two. This also involved the hydrogen, but this is the elimination of direct hydrogen. So this will be the faster as compared to these two reductive eliminations. One thing to be remembered is that reductive elimination is shown by the metals at their higher oxidation state. Why? Because the oxidation state will going to reduce in this process. So the complexes metal should be in its higher oxidation states so that reductive elimination process can take place. Like this oxidative addition reaction, this reductive elimination reactions, they are also of two types. You've already studied about the oxidative addition reactions. They are of mononuclear and binuclear type. So likewise, these reductive elimination reactions, they are also of two types. Single metal center base, which are known as mononuclear. And these are also known as two electron change type of reductive elimination. So this is the example of where the two electron change in the electron count, two change in the oxidation state, and two change in the coordination number. So these are -2 because their coordination number of metal will decrease by 2. The oxidation state of the metal will decrease by 2. And the electron count will be decreased by 2. So these are the complexes, D8 metals like nickel, palladium, aurium, and D6 metals like these. This kind of reductive elimination will take place. So this is the simple example which I have shown you the initially in the introduction of reductive elimination reaction. The other type of reductive elimination reaction is two metal center. It is also known as binuclear or bimetallic or one electron change reductive elimination. So you can see that there are two metal centers. So this is bimetallic, this is binuclear. So two metal centers, and these two metal centers here XY will reductively eliminate so that the change in electron count and the change in coordination number and the change in oxidation state will be 1. So it will reduces, the electron count will reduces by 1, the oxidation state will reduces by 1, and the coordination number will reduces by 1. So these are the example of one electron change or binuclear or bimetallic or two metal center. There are two metal centers. Okay, so two metal center reductive elimination reactions. Now in case of mononuclear reductive elimination, mononuclear reductive elimination means single metal center based reductive elimination. So in this mononuclear reductive elimination, groups to be eliminated should be cis to each other on a metal center. So this is the prime condition for reductive elimination of this mononuclear type, that the eliminated groups should be cis to each other on a metal center. So I am showing you an example. This is the example of mononuclear reductive elimination. In this complex, you can see that these two methyl groups, they are at cis position to each other. This is a palladium complex, and after reductive elimination, this PD will convert into PD0. We have not shown the other ligands, but we have shown only the PD, that its oxidation state will decrease from second to zero, and then CH3 and ethane molecule will be this eliminated at 80 degree centigrade in presence of dimethyl sulfoxide. Now, in the case of this complex, this is a platinum complex. It is also platinum second complex. And here you can see that these two methyl groups, they are trans to each other. So at the same condition, at 80 degrees centigrade and DMSO, in presence of DMSO, no reaction will take place. Why? Because these two methyl groups, which are to be eliminated, they are at the trans position on the same metal center, so they cannot eliminate. So for bimolecular, for mononuclear, reductive elimination reaction, the two eliminating groups should be cis to each other. In case of bimolecular या binuclear, this is binuclear, not bimolecular. It is binuclear reductive elimination occurs generally in first row transition metal complexes. Can also occur sometimes in 4D and 5D metals, but generally, this is the general trend that first row transition metal elements, they show binuclear type reductive elimination. In some cases, 4D and 5D can also show the reductive elimination, binuclear type reductive elimination reaction. So in this case, you can see that this also shows, this is all the example of osmium or any other complex here. In presence of temperature, if we increase the temperature or in presence of this sunlight, there is binuclear type reductive elimination. One ligand from here, this center, and one ligand from this center, they will eliminate together and form this product. So this is a kind of reductive elimination. This occurs in the 4D and 5D series rarely, but this is example of this is not the example of 3D series, but generally, which compounds, which elements can show the reductive elimination of binuclear type, they are 3D series. But sometimes 4D and 5D series, they also show this binuclear type reductive elimination reaction. Now, why we are studying the reductive elimination reaction? Why we are studying? So, what is the importance of this reductive elimination reaction? So, the importance of reductive elimination reaction is that it occurs during different industrial processes, a lot of industrial processes. The reaction mechanism explains about the reductive elimination to be the last step of the homogeneous catalytic cycles. So, this occurs during hydrogenation, during Monsanto acetic acid process, during cross-coupling reactions, Weber's process, hydroformylation reaction, etc. So, this reductive elimination reaction is an important reaction because it is the intermediate step. Actually, it is the last step of homogeneous catalytic cyclic processes. Now, we will discuss about the mechanism of reductive elimination. So, we have studied the reaction mechanism of oxidative addition reaction. So, likewise, in case of reductive elimination, the same type of mechanism can describe the reductive elimination reaction. So, these are the different mechanisms through which reductive elimination can take place that are concerted mechanisms. You have already studied in the oxidative addition reactions. Concerted mechanism means three-center transition state. Okay, so in this case also, in transition, this in reductive elimination reactions also, they can occur through three-center transition state. So that will be the concerted mechanism. During this mechanism, the retention of stereochemistry, the retention of the configuration of the reactant will occur. Okay, there may be SN2 mechanism where the inversion of configuration will take place, and these can also occur through radical mechanism. But usually, we will discuss about the concerted mechanism, which is a easy mechanism, an easy mechanism to understand the reductive elimination reactions. So we will concentrate on the concerted mechanism of reductive elimination. Now, one more important thing, that rate of reductive elimination depends upon metal complex geometry. Okay. So, rate will depends upon metal complex geometry. Geometry means either it is octahedral complex or it is a square planar complex. So, we will discuss each complex reductive elimination process one by one. So how the reductive elimination in an octahedral complex can take place, and how the reductive elimination in a square planar complex can take place, we will discuss one by one. As we have pointed out that the rate of reductive elimination depends upon metal complex geometry. So we will discuss about the octahedral complexes, how this geometry affects the reductive elimination reaction. So we will first study the octahedral complexes, reductive elimination in octahedral complexes, then we will take the examples of square planar complexes. So in case of octahedral complexes, reductive elimination is generally slow and it proceeds through dissociative pathway. So generally the reductive elimination in the octahedral complexes, it proceeds through dissociative mechanism. So in this octahedral complex, we are studying the dissociative pathway of reductive elimination. So this is the pathway of reductive elimination in octahedral complex. So if you can see that this is a complex of rhodium where its oxidation state is 3. And it is an 18 electron system and its geometry is octahedral. You can see that there are 6 ligands with the rhodium third. So in this complex, first this ligand, this bulkier ligand, will eliminate, it will dissociate. So dissociation step will be the slow step. So this is the dissociation of this octahedral geometry into square pyramidal geometry. Okay, so during this dissociation, only the coordination number will decrease. Here the coordination number is 6. Here the coordination number becomes 5. So decrease by 1 unit. So coordination number decreased and the electron count will decrease by 2, because one ligand can donate 2 electrons to this rhodium. So this becomes 16 electron system. It is the original reactant was 18 electron system, while after elimination of or a dissociation of this PME3 ligand, it becomes 16 electron species, which is square pyramidal in shape. You can see that these 4, they are in the planar and this H is in the pyramid position. Then after this, this species will convert into an intermediate, that is Y type distorted trigonal bipyramidal transition state. So this will convert immediately into distorted trigonal bipyramidal transition state. In this transition state, you will see that the eliminating species which will come closer. So eliminating species are H and CH3COME. So these will come closer and they will form a Y type distorted trigonal geometry, in which a ligand that is pi donor, in this case it is Cl. So it will be far away from these two eliminating groups. So on the one side these two eliminating groups are there, and on the other side this Cl will present, which is a pi donor ligand. And again you can see that they come closer, these two groups, they come closer, because for reductive elimination they should be cis. Okay, so this is a mononuclear type reductive elimination. So in this case the eliminated group should be in the cis position. So again you can see that from here to here this species is third, its oxidation state remains third. So at this point, these two groups will eliminate in the form of CH3COME, and then this will remains as such. So in here you can see that the oxidation state will reduce from third to one. So change in oxidation state will minus two. From here to here it is minus two, and then electron count will also be minus two. Okay. Then its coordination number also changed from 5 to 3. So coordination number change will be minus 2 by 2. It reduces by 2 and it becomes a 14 electron system. it is 18 electron system, then it becomes 16 electron. These all are 16, and after this electron count will decrease by 2, so it becomes a 14 electron system. And then the ligand that has been dissociated, that will add it to this compound, and then you can see that it again becomes 4 coordinated compound, but its oxidation state of rhodium will remains the same. So in this way you can see that it again becomes 16 electron species, and it becomes square planar in shape. So you can see that this is the reactant and this is the product. So during this reductive elimination reaction, this third will reduce to 1. So total change in coordination number will be in oxidation state will be 2. Okay, coordination number is 6 here, and here coordination number is 4. So reduction of coordination number from 6 to 4. And electron count, it is a 18 electron species, and while this is a 16 electron species. So if we see, again I am repeating, if we see from here to here, only the electron count will change and coordination number will change, oxidation state will remain the same. So in these complexes, in these intermediates also, the same condition will be as that of this compound. So it will also has 5 coordination number, 3 oxidation state of RH, and it is a 16 electron system. After this, you can see that after elimination of CST-COME, then you can see that it has 5 coordination number, it has 3 coordination number. So change in coordination number will be minus 2. Change in electron count will be minus 2, as in case of oxidative addition, if we add this group to this, then 2 electron count will increase. Okay. Now oxidation state, it is plus 3 and it is plus 1. So the change in oxidation state will be minus 2. From here to here, you can see that the electron count will increase by 2 because one ligand is added. Here 3 ligands, here 4 ligands. So this can donate 2 electrons to this RH. So again, this 14 electron species will convert into 16 electron species. This is trigonal planar species. And this will convert into this kind of species. This is square planar species. And you can see that coordination number difference is also 1. But overall, if we see the overall reaction, then we can see that in the overall reaction, we can see, if we see this reactant and this product, then we can see that this is the reduction in oxidation state by 2. The reduction in electron count by 2, 18 electron species, it is 16 electron species. And the reduction in the coordination number by 2, it has the 6 coordination number and it has 4 coordination number. So I will show you the complete picture of this mechanism so that you can take a screenshot of this mechanism. So this is the whole mechanism. You can take a screenshot of this mechanism so that it will be clear to you that how this dissociative mechanism is occurring. So in case of dissociative mechanism, you can see that the first step is dissociation. That's why it is called as dissociative pathway. Now the second type of complexes are square planar complexes, because the geometry affects the rate of reductive elimination reactions. So now we will, after studying the octahedral complexes, then we will study about the square planar complexes. So how reductive elimination can take place in square planar complexes? So in square planar complexes, reductive elimination can take place, can proceed through 3 mechanisms. One, it may be dissociative type, it may be non-dissociative type, it may be associative type. So these are the 3 mechanisms by which the reductive elimination can proceed in square planar complexes. So we will discuss one by one each mechanism. So this is a dissociative mechanism. And this dissociative mechanism, it generally occurs when, in this case, when there is lower concentration of PPH3 ligand. So in this case, if PPH3 concentration is lower, then the reductive elimination will take place through dissociative mechanism. So in this case, we can see this is a palladium complex, एंड दीज टू ग्रुप्स दे आर गोइंग टू एलिमिनेट. ओके, सो दैट इन द फर्स्ट केस, इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप यू कैन सी दैट देयर इज डिसोसिएशन ऑफ वन PPH3 ग्रुप. जनरली कैटालिटिक रिएक्शंस दे प्रोसीड वाया elimination of the bulkier ligands. Okay, so from this complex one PPH3 will eliminate, then it has coordination number 4 and its oxidation state is +2. After elimination of this PPH3, this PD will have coordination number 3. So only 3 ligands are there and there is a reduction in its oxidation state, it becomes +1. And when we heat this complex, heat in presence of PPH3, but the concentration of PPH3 is low, then these groups can eliminate, these will eliminate, and they further reduces the PD1 to PD0. This will add to this PD and its oxidation state will becomes 0. Okay, so you can see that here its oxidation state is 2 and after formation of product its oxidation state will become 0. Its coordination number is 4 and its coordination number is 2. So reduction is the coordination number. Again, two groups are eliminated, so its electron count will decrease by 2. So this is dissociative mechanism where the first step is dissociation. So the mechanism is suggested as a dissociative mechanism if the first step is dissociative. Okay, then we will study the second mechanism of square planar complexes. The second mechanism is non-dissociative mechanism. So, as the name is indicating that non-dissociative, there is no dissociation in the slow step. So, it will occur generally in the higher concentration of PPH3. So, if there is a higher concentration of PPH3, then this PPH3 cannot be eliminated in the first step. Okay, so this will be the non-dissociative type mechanism. So in this mechanism, you can see that this is a compound, that is the original compound. At this compound, in this compound, these two groups, they are to be eliminated. So when we heat this compound in presence of PPH3, so the concentration of PPH3 will be higher. So that these two groups, they will eliminate and convert this PD2 to PD0. So this is a direct process where no dissociation of any ligand will take place in the first step. So it is non-dissociative mechanism. In the first step, the eliminating groups will eliminate. In the rate determining step, when we heat such kind of compound, and in presence of higher concentration of PPH3, it will convert into PD0, so that its coordination number will decrease, its oxidation state will decrease, and its electron count will also decrease. So it is reductive elimination reaction that is occurring via non-dissociative mechanism. Now the third mechanism is associative mechanism. Now this associative mechanism, it occurs in such kind of compounds. Okay. This associative mechanism, it occurs in this compound, nickel compound is there. So in this case, first one group, one ligand can associate with this metal center. In case of square planar complexes, this will first add to this nickel center. So the first rate determining step, that is slow, is associate type, because in the first step this will going to add in this metal center. So this metal center is having 4 coordination number. After addition of such kind of groups, its coordination number become 5. Okay, so coordination number first increase, and after this is the transition state where the coordination number is 5. This is square pyramidal type complex. So after this addition of this group, immediately these two groups which are in the cis position to each other, they will eliminate, and they will eliminate in the form of CH3CH3, that is C2H6, and this group is attached to this NI group. So you can see that its coordination number decreased. So coordination number decreased, and then its electron count will also decrease, and its oxidation state will also decrease. So it is associative mechanism for square planar complexes for reductive elimination. So elimination of these two groups will take place, and with the elimination, the oxidation state of nickel will decrease, as well as its coordination number will also decrease. So there are three mechanisms by which we can study the reductive elimination in square planar complexes. Now we will study about the factors affecting reductive elimination. So what are the factors that affects the reductive elimination reactions? So because there are two types of compounds in a organometallic compound, one is metal and other is ligand. So it is indicating that metal and the ligand's nature will going to affect the reductive elimination. So we will study one by one each factor with the help of example. So if we see how this metal type and electron density on metal that is going to affect the reductive elimination, then there are some points to be remembered. That first or 3D series metal complexes, they undergo faster reductive elimination as compared to second and third series of metal complexes. Why this occurs? So they will undergo faster reductive elimination. I have already told you that the first series of transition elements complexes, they undergo faster reductive elimination because the ML bond is weaker as compared to 4D and 5D series elements. So these 4D and 5D elements, they overlap strongly and form a strong ML bond, so that they undergo the bond breaking will be very difficult for 4D and 5D series metal complexes. So the reductive elimination will be slower in case of 4D and 5D series as compared to the 3D series. Now the electron density on metal, it also affects the reductive elimination reactions. So electron poor metal center will undergo faster reductive elimination as compared to the electron deficient metal centers. Electron efficient metal centers. This is efficient. Okay. So this is electron efficient metal centers, electron rich metal centers. So electron poor metal centers, if we compare the electron poor metal centers and electron efficient metal centers, then we can compare the oxidation state of metal centers. So electron poor metal centers will have higher oxidation state, while the electron efficient metal centers, they will have lower oxidation state. Because in reductive elimination, the oxidation state will decrease. So the metal center that has to be undergo reductive elimination reaction, that should be electron poor, that should be in its higher oxidation state, so that it can reduce its oxidation state. Okay, so we are discussing about its metal center. So number of electrons in metal center should be less, so that it can reduce, and there will be increase in the electron count of the metal center. Now if we see how the ligand can affect the reductive elimination reaction. So how the ligand, so there are a number of factors of ligand which can affect the reductive elimination reactions. So number one is the steric effect. So ligand's steric effect will going to affect the reductive elimination. More strictly hindered center will show faster reductive elimination, because strictly hindered ligands can easily eliminate because they are creating hysteric hindrance in the molecule. So they will easily eliminate, and they will increase the rate of reductive elimination reaction. So I will explain with the help of example how hysteric hindrance that will affect the rate of reductive elimination reactions. So this is the series of some ligands. This is triphenylphosphine ligand, and in this triphenylphosphine you can observe that there are three phenyl groups. So this ligand become bulkier. One phenyl group is replaced by methyl group in this ligand, so it will be less bulkier. And in case of PME3, all the pH they are replaced by ME ligand. So if we differentiate the steric hindrance of these ligands, then we will find that this ligand, due to its bulkier nature, there will be more steric hindrance. So this ligand can easily reductively eliminate. So this kind of ligand will helpful in increasing the rate of reductive elimination reaction. Now if we compare this PF3 with this ME3 ligand, then we will find that this F ligand has a smaller size as compared to this ME, but the electronegativity of F is very high. So due to higher electronegativity, it will create electron deficiency on the metal center. So one more condition for reductive elimination is that the metal center should be electron deficient. Okay, so due to presence of this less bulkier electronegative group, in spite of its small size, its electronegativity will affect the rate of reductive elimination reaction. So if PF3 will be present as a ligand, and in another compound PME3 will be the ligand, then the reductive elimination will be faster in case of PF3 ligand due to the electronegative nature of this F, which will create deficiency on the metal center, and this will accelerate the rate of reductive elimination. The other factor is the presence of hydride ligand. So if there is presence of hydride, then the reductive elimination will be faster. This point we have already been discussed in the introductory part. Now the coordination number will also affects rate of reductive elimination reaction, coordination number of metal. So in case of 3 or 5 coordinated complexes, this is the odd number of coordination number. So these complexes, they show faster rate of reductive elimination as compared to 4 and 6 coordinated metal centers. The other ligand related the factor that affects the rate of reductive elimination reactions is chelating ligand. So if there is monodentate ligand, and in another complex there is chelating ligands, then reductive elimination will increase towards monodentate ligand. So if a ligand is having chelating property, then the complex will not easily undergo reductive elimination. So the example is this compound. So in this compound you can see that this is a chelating ligand. So this type of complex cannot undergo reductive elimination easily because there is a chelating ligand. So chelating ligand also affect the rate of reductive elimination. The other factor is the position of ligands that are going to eliminate. So if the groups that are going to eliminate, if they are present in the transposition to each other, then they are not prone to reductive elimination. So in such kind of complex in which the two groups which are going to eliminate, if they are present in the transposition, then no reductive elimination will take place. So these are the different factors that affects the rate of reductive elimination reaction. Now we will conclude the reductive elimination. Reductive elimination is actually the reverse of oxidative addition. It is having two words, that is, one is reductive and other is elimination. So reductive means reduction in terms of oxidation state. So during reductive elimination, number one, the oxidation state of the metal center decreased, then its electron count will decrease and its coordination number will decrease. This is the reductive part. And what is the elimination part? The elimination part is that two groups present in the cis position, they can eliminate so that the reductive elimination can take place. So this reductive elimination can be mononuclear or binuclear. It will depend upon the complex, which type of complex is that. And then there are several factors which affects the reductive elimination rate. They are the ligands as well as the metal. And we also studied about the different mechanisms, because the rate of reductive elimination is affected by the type of complexes. So we have studied the mechanism of octahedral complex, mechanism of reductive elimination in octahedral complexes and in square planar complexes. So in octahedral complexes, the reductive elimination occurs through dissociative mechanism, while in case of square planar complexes, the reductive elimination proceeds via dissociative, non-dissociative and associative mechanism. So this is all about reductive elimination. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the migratory insertion reactions. Thank you very much.